Hello, Kusto community. My name is Ryan Majitimer. I'm a product manager on the Azure Synapse Analytics team. And today I'm joined by Akshay Dixit, who's a product manager on the Azure Data Explorer team for this episode of Azure Data Explorer 101. We're going to be talking about out-of-the-box visualization capabilities for Kusto Web Explorer. I'm going to hand it over to Akshay. Welcome.
Thank you, Ryan. Hi, everyone. My name is Akshay Dixit, and I'm a product manager in Azure Data Explorer group. Today, we are going to explore out-of-box visualizations in Kusto Web Explorer using KQL Render Operator. As you know, ADX is a fast, highly scalable data exploration service for log and telemetry data. It is used to build complex analytic solutions for vast amount of data where data visualization and reporting forms the critical step. Visualizing your data, transforming it into actionable insights, and sharing the results across your organization within time can make a huge positive impact on your business. Query visualizations are also helpful in detecting, forecasting, machine learning, and many more scenarios. ADX integrates with various visualization tools such as Power BI, Grafana, Kibana, Qlik, Tableau, just to name a few. You may choose the one that best fits your use case and budget. Apart from this, KQL Render Operator offers various visualizations such as tables, pie charts, bar charts, column charts to depict the query result. Let me quickly share my screen to learn more about this. The Render Operator instructs the user agent to render a visualization of the query results. It does not modify the data, and it must be the last operator in the query. It can only be used with the queries that produce a single tabular data stream result. To use this operator, you must begin with the table input name, followed by the render command, and the type of visualization that you want to use. This can be followed with optional properties. Let us now take a look at a few demos. The table could be the most simple visualization. Here, we are using the storm events table, which is a sample data set on the Kusto Help cluster. As you can see, when we run the query with render table command, a table is rendered with the columns of storm event table. Since the visual is default in KQL, if we run this query even without the render command, the same result would be displayed. Therefore, we do not need to explicitly call the render operator if we want to visualize a table. The next visualization that I want to show you is called a card visual. This visual is handy when you want to display a singular metric or KPI. It shows only one element. If there are multiple rows or columns in the output, only the first result record shows up on the card. The title is an optional property for the visual where you can display a string title on the card. The column chart needs a minimum of two columns in the query result. By default, the first column is used as the x-axis. This column can contain text, date time, or numeric data types. The other columns are used as y-axis, containing numeric data types to be displayed in the vertical lines. Column charts are used for comparing specific subcategory items in a main category range, where the length of each line represents its value. The bar chart visual also needs a minimum of two columns. However, contrary to the column chart visual, the first column here is used as the y-axis. Bar charts are mainly used for comparing numeric and nominal discrete values. Next, let's take a look at the pie chart visual. The first column here is used as the color axis. It can contain text, date time, or numeric data types. The other columns are numbers, which would be used to determine the size of each slice. Pie charts are used for presenting a composition of categories and their proportions out of a total. Here, we have specified the title of the pie chart using the optional property. Another very basic visual is the line chart. Here, The first column forms the x-axis and should be numeric. Other columns also should be numeric and form the y-axis. Line charts track the changes over short and long periods of time. When smaller changes exist, line charts are more useful than bar charts. In a scatter chart visual, both x and y-axis should be numeric columns. Scatter plots are used to observe relationship between variables. The scatter chart visual can also be used in the context of geospatial visualizations. Geospatial visualizations are covered in another ADX 101 video by Henning. Do check it out in case you want to learn more on this topic. In this example, we have summarized the property damage by state and then rendered a scatter chart with optional properties such as title and the x-axis title. To produce a cleaner looking chart, we have also hidden the legend. The area chart visual shows a time series relationship. The first column, which forms the x-axis, should be numeric. Other numeric columns form the y-axis. Unlike line charts, area charts visually represent volume. Area charts are ideal for indicating the change among different data sets. You can stack the area charts using stacked area chart visual. This visual is similar to area chart, but shows the area under each element of a series. Here we are using the NYC taxi dataset, which is a dataset in Kusto Health Cluster, with the X column being the date and time when the passengers were picked up, and the count of passengers occupying the taxi being the series. It is easy to follow with this visualization that the highest volume of taxi usage in New York City is single occupancy. A time chart is a special type of line graph where the x-axis is always time. Here, we have selected one time series from the demo time series table in the help cluster and decomposed it using the series decompose function. Here in this visual, you can easily see the baseline, the residual, the seasonality, and the trend of the time series on the x-axis of time. The anomaly chart visualization is similar to the time chart, but highlights anomalies using the series decompose anomaly function. To learn more about anomaly detection and forecasting in ADX, do check out the anomaly detection and forecasting video by Adi in ADX 101 series. You can pin any of these visual queries to the ADX dashboard and share it across your organization by navigating to Share and choosing Pin to Dashboard and selecting either the existing dashboard or creating a new dashboard and clicking on Pin. Please watch the ADX 101 dashboard video by Gabi for more on what you can do with ADX dashboards. Hope you were able to learn about the out-of-box visualization capabilities in KQL with Kusto Web Explorer. That's all I had to share with you in this instance of ADX 101. Thank you very much. Back to you, Ryan.
Well, that wraps up our video for today. Thanks, Akshay, for joining us. Tell us in the comments, did you enjoy these out-of-the-box KQL visualizations? I bet you did. I certainly did. Again, my name is Ryan Majitimer. You can find me on Twitter. More importantly, you can find Azure Data Explorer on Twitter, AZ Data Explorer. Like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.